Rev it up and welcome to Cars Yeah, show number 2425. Today we're going to learn and talk about car care, something near and dear to my heart, big part of my life, all the way back to the days when I started a car care business at the young age of 14. So be prepared to learn a little, learn a lot, and be inspired.
This is Cars Yeah, where you'll enjoy interviews with inspiring automotive enthusiasts. Mark Green is here to provide you with a fuel injection of automotive inspiration. So get in, sit down, buckle up, and get ready for a wild ride here on Cars Yeah.
Hello, inspiring automotive enthusiasts, and welcome to Cars Yeah. Today I'm in Irvine, California, with a very special and longtime friend by the name of Mike Pennington. Mike, welcome back to Cars Yeah. Do you have any gear, and are you ready to release the clutch?
We are ready to roll, and it's great to be back.
Well, this is fun, and I'll tell you, listeners, I met Mike so long ago. He taught me how to use a random orbital. He shared a lot of car care techniques that I took with me into the career that I had for a long time. And so I kind of feel like I'm talking to a real old friend, but I'm not going to call you old because I'm the old one here. But I will say before I introduce you as a key integral part of Meguiar's, how many years have you been at Meguiar's?
Do I dare say? Because that is going to make me old, I think.
I don't know about
I
that.
I just celebrated 34 years at Meguiar's and have loved every single minute of it.
Oh, my gosh. That's just incredible. Yeah, they just can't get rid of you. So,
yeah, I don't know if it's I can't get rid of them or they can't get rid of me. It's probably, you know, a mutual love is what it is. I'm hoping at least.
Yeah, well, I'm sure it is. I'm telling you something that, you know, this whole podcast of mine here I started 9.5 years ago was all about people that have figured out how to wrap their passions into their lives. And you are the quintessential example of that. Of course, I've had many, but for somebody that loves what they do and has been doing it for as long as they have, and as long as you've been giving back to people by helping them do a better job and learn things, you've kind of figured out the secret sauce to life, my friend.
I don't know if I stumbled into it or by design, probably a little bit of everything. And it is the love of my life. So that's why I'm still here.
Well, it's pretty, pretty cool. Now, I didn't ask you this because you're a three-peater now. This is your third appearance on Cars Yeah. Mike was a guest way back when I was trying to figure this all out. You were so nice to be guest number 283 back in 2015. And then I guess I did an okay job because you came back in 2017 as show number 697 to share some new things that Meguiar's was doing at the time after the SEMA show. And that's what we're going to be talking about today. And before I give you a little bit more of a proper introduction here, I didn't ask you this last time you're on the show. What's one little thing that maybe people don't know about you since they know so much about you from the car care world?
Oh, that is a great question. So let's see, outside of work, here's a great one. I don't think a lot of people know that I love dogs.
Cool.
My wife and I both are very big dog lovers, supporters. We work closely with some charities, some law enforcement charities, Orange County Police K-9 Association. So that's something that, you know, I don't think a lot of people do know. Awesome. That might be listening.
Well, who doesn't love a dog? I mean, they're just the best. So, well, let me introduce you here, and we're going to dive into what happened at SEMA and new products. So here we go. Mike Pennington is the Global Director of Training and Consumer Relations for Meguiar's, the world's leading surface care company. He oversees the company's technical training programs and customer care center. He also works closely with their R&D department to help study and develop new car care products. He has training for outside sales staff and conducts a wide variety of hands-on classes to teach and train users on the entire Meguiar's surface care brand. And as I said today, he's going to talk about some new products, what's going on in the industry, and give us some tips and tricks for all of us do-it-yourselfers out there that love to keep our vehicles looking new. But first, a word from our sponsor. So give them a little love, and we'll be right back. Get your microfiber out. We're going to have some fun. Years ago, when it was time to renew my collector car insurance policy, my carrier's rates went up, way up. But my usage was the same, and I never made a claim. I didn't even have a ticket. So what's with that? So I turned to American Collectors Insurance. Has your collector car insurance recently raised your rates for no good reason? Tired of paying an annual membership fee? Then it's time to look around and call American Collectors Insurance. I shopped around, I asked friends for recommendations, and found a winner that I can trust. And boy, I'm glad I did. I saved hundreds of dollars every year and slept better at night knowing my baby was properly insured. American Collectors Insurance have been protecting vehicles since 1976. They provided me with an agreed value insurance policy backed by their history of taking great care of their clients. What could be better than that? So give them a call and ask for a quote today. 866-ACI-YAH. That's 866-224-9324. And protect the ones you love like I did with American Collectors Insurance. Classic car insurance designed by collectors for collectors. For several years now, you've heard me talk about Linkage Magazine. I've been a subscriber since the start. Their talented and creative team brings you a spectacular publication and website that shares the automotive passion from a worldwide perspective. Linkage is about driving, restoring, collecting, and firsthand experience at collector car auctions and more. They bring you real-world values plus rational, experienced opinions on the current markets. They cover the automotive world and the people who share our passions. And Linkage Magazine has grown, mailing you 6 issues annually. Join me on this journey with Linkage. They're geared for the automotive life. You can subscribe at linkagemag.com. So, Mike, I want to start off by talking about SEMA, because I had a family obligation and I missed SEMA. Would have been my 32nd year, I believe. This was like your 35th year going to SEMA. So give us some of your, now that you've had a few weeks to kind of catch up and catch a breath here, of your observations of how was SEMA this year?
I think a couple words come to mind, and it's interesting, is it did not disappoint, and SEMA never disappoints.
Yes.
Especially, you know, I mean, with 2020 COVID being the first year ever that SEMA didn't happen, it has been a slow build back, but clearly the numbers were back to pre-COVID days, and I think even better than pre-COVID days that I heard some early numbers. So huge crowd, huge energy. It was just out of this world, as always.
Yeah, it is. It's spectacular. Now, Meguiar's always has a major presence at SEMA. They have for a long, long time. So tell me a little bit about the booth that you had there, maybe some of the car. You guys always had the coolest cars in your booth, maybe some of the vehicles that were parked in there under the lights.
Well, that's one. You talk about, we call it the cars of the stars, the eye candy. And it's funny, this year, you know, if you walk the show, you know, you got hot rods, classic muscle, modern muscle, exotic, JDMs. That's what I personally love about the show, is everything is represented, lifted, lowered trucks, you name it, it's there. But this is the first year that we actually moved our booth to a new location in Central Hall, which was great. But we featured two fantastic cars, and both are kind of U.S. debuts, you could call it almost, or unveilings. The first was a 1970 Barracuda that came all the way from Australia, and it's called Notorious. So I encourage everybody to, you know, look up Notorious Barracuda right now, and you'll be amazed if you didn't get a chance to see it. Beautiful stunner, hand-fabricated. By Rise by Cam. I mean, it was just a stunner, is a word that a lot of people used. And the other was a little bit different style. It was a 2022 BMW M4 that was fitted with the true GT3 body kit built by TJ Hunt out of San Diego. And that car had such a, you know, it had a legitimate air jacks on it, like an Indy car. And it was just amazing in its own right. The color, the stance, the look, the feel, the perception, I mean, just the image it gave. I mean, it was so two totally different cars, and they were both stunners in their own right.
Wow, you guys always have the coolest stuff. Now, one of the things before we get into what's new at Meguiar's, because I love to talk about car care, is you guys last year, I believe right now you're celebrating 1 year, you moved to a new corporate headquarters there in Irvine. Now, I visited you, and this has to be over 30 years ago, I believe, when I came to your headquarters to learn a little bit about random orbital machines and car care and so forth. You guys are in a new place, and I want you to talk a little bit about this, because a lot of people look at Meguiar's, and of course, Barry Meguiar, the name behind Meguiar's, the family and so forth. But what some people don't know is that 3M bought you guys some time ago, but they kind of let you alone, other than supporting you tremendously. And it's obvious in your growth, they've given you lots of support. But what's new at the new headquarters?
You hit everything perfect there. And it's obviously, with Barry being that third generation of the family, we were acquired, and you said it perfectly. A lot of people still don't know that 3M acquired us in 2008, and here we are in, what, 2023?
Yeah.
So it's been a great acquisition. You said it. They support us, believe in us, and really want the hobby to thrive, the brand to thrive, and it's been a very good transition. Have we been acquired too long to be a transition? I don't know if I could even say that anymore.
Well, you know, if you're growing, you're always transitioning. That's how I look at it.
At some point. But it was 1 year ago, that building you went to, Mark, remember, that's the building we moved into today. So we moved into that other building in Irvine, December of 1989. And I know that so well because I had started working several months before that, moved into that building. And now, 1 year ago, I mean, it was a busy 2022 SEMA. We had the SEMA show, fantastic. We came back and had to move two buildings and all employees into where we landed now, which is still in Irvine, about 9 miles away from the place you're familiar with. All new studio for filming, creating content, you know, editing bays, voiceover booths, a brand new lab where we create all of our own formulas. A training area for in-person, different bays, dry bays, wet bays, air-conditioned car wash bay. Hallelujah on that one.
Nice. Especially after the summer we had, right?
Especially in that other building over there. I can just remember it was some hot days washing, but now those are behind us. So now we're looking through that windshield. And then certainly, you know, upstairs is all new workstations, new work areas, new collaboration areas, kitchens, meeting rooms. I mean, it is state of the art. So proud. And next time you're in Southern California, we'd love to get you to this building and just to do a, let's call it a tour of our new facility.
Yeah, I come down. My mom and sister live down there, and definitely, in fact, I'll be down there probably for the La Jolla Concours next April. So I got to add a few days to come visit you. So I will take you up on that.
Please do.
Sure.
We're right by, and I think you know the area. Yeah, we're just really South Orange County, right at the Spectrum 5405 interchange there is where we're located.
My mom's in Laguna Niguel there, and my sister's in Rancho Mission Viejo. So you're right down the street. So we will definitely have some fun for sure.
Looking forward to it. I'm going to hold you to it now.
Okay. That sounds like fun. So I want to talk about what's new with Meguiar's, because you guys are the kings of rolling out new products every year. You just never stop. You don't rest on your laurels. And the car care industry, you know, my dealings in car care goes back to when I was 14. I started working on cars to make extra money so I could buy surfboards. And I used your products way back when, and it's so funny how things have progressed into the future now. So I want to talk about, perhaps let's start with some new things that you launched at SEMA.
Well, we actually, it's interesting you say, yes, we like to launch. And obviously there's the DIY side of the business, you know, the retail, do it in your garage, do it in your driveway. And we launched 5 of those items. But if we can't forget that our pro business, you know, detailers, body shops and the like, that's really what put us on the map through the early, you know, 1930s on up through until 1973 when we launched our first retail product. So we launched 3 of those new professional products at the same time. So it's been a busy year for us. And all new items were received well. And it was funny, you know, the more we kind of were going through SEMA and thinking about some of these items, a couple of these items were just ahas, like, why didn't we launch this a long time ago?
Sometimes that's the way life is.
It is, you know. Consumers can only ask so many times, why don't you have this? And then a couple of the other products were technology improvements and jumps in technology. So, for example, a glass cleaner, if you combine our technology of our glass cleaner, like our perfect clarity that we've had for years, with some of the properties we leverage in our waxes and polishes to create beading and all rain repellency. Why have we never launched a glass cleaner that has both in it? So we finally did this year, launched our ultimate glass cleaner and water repellent.
Ooh.
It's a simple combination of quality glass cleaning with a little bit of rain repellency. Now, we must say it's not a glass coating. It's not designed to last forever because think how often you clean your glass. You're doing it frequently, so you're cleaning off and adding, boosting, enhancing a little bit of that extra, let's call it hydrophobic properties. And that's kind of just an aha, like, huh, why didn't we have that a long time ago? with our technology.
Yeah, for me, I live up here in the Pacific Northwest, and it rains a little bit, like every day. And I'm going to go and grab a bottle of that and give it a try because it's, you know, it's, yeah, glass is clarity and being able to see down the road is so important, and the safety of that, especially at night, and having something that adds a repellent to it. What's the word I'm looking for?
Hydrophobic? Hydrophobic?
I just invented a new word. You can use that as a marketing tool next year.
They work, actually.
Aquaphobic.
The same thing.
I like that. Aquaphobic. Okay, I better trademark that.
Heard that here first right now.
There you go. Yeah, exactly. I think that's tremendous. So bravo to you. And it's basically, is it a spray-on wipe-off product?
That's all it is. So it's keep it simple. Premium quality microfiber. You know, grab one that's designed for glass. This combination, again, it's just kind of an aha, like, Man, this is such a great product. We should have launched this years ago. Like, it was pretty simple to come up with, which is odd, but wonderful. I've been playing with it for months and love it.
The name of that again is, so that listeners get it down?
It is our Ultimate Glass Cleaner and Water Repellent.
Okay, cool.
So it's branded under our Ultimate line. The next one is another aha to highlight is a couple of years ago, we launched a hybrid ceramic wash and wax. That was a two-component product where you had the wash, you mixed wash, and then you had a little separate vial, almost like the old two-stroke days of motorcycles where you had to add it together.
Oh, yeah.
And that, remember those? We're dating ourselves now, but I heard they're coming back.
I have to do that on my leaf blower, so yeah. Got it.
So technology-wise, it was fantastic, but a lot of, you know, consumers we talked to, I'm sure a lot of the listeners right now are going to say, yeah, but I didn't know how much. I put too much of that. I didn't put enough. The mixture was wrong. I'm not accustomed to that. So finally, the R&D said, okay, we'll go back to the kitchen. We will make let's call it one component, standard hybrid ceramic wash and wax that you don't need to do anything. You just mix 2 ounces per gallon in a bucket. Or, of course, foam cannons are all the rage these days. So put 6 parts of water to 1 part of this product in a foam cannon, and you're going to have quality cleaning. You're going to be leaving behind some of that, you know, let's call it hybrid ceramic properties that we've brought to the market. And it's simple and easy to use. No more mixing, no more running out of one before the other. So we think we solved that little bit of challenge that the consumers were kind of talking about.
Nice. I love it. Yeah. Yeah. When you know, us guys tend to always want to put more. And I always use the analogy, you know, if you use a fertilizer on your lawn, it's not good to put more.
Yeah.
They figured out how much to put in. And so when you got to start doing this stuff, most of the things, or many times the mistake people will make is they just put too much product as a water to product ratio. You don't need to waste it that way. It's been figured out for you, right?
Yeah, let the pros do what they do. No matter what your favorite brand is, you know, everybody has quality chemists, and there's a lot of great products to choose from out there. In fact, that's one of the things we like to teach people is, you know, choose the right product, use it correctly, and that's when you're going to get those wow results. So read that label. It's got great information on how to mix it, how much to use, sunlight, no sunlight, what toweling, and that's really going to make your, you know, let's call it your result, be better than you expect versus less than you expected.
There you go. Learn from the pro. So what's up next?
The next one is an interesting one I'll highlight. I think it's going to be ceramic coating is a big word. Wouldn't you agree on that one, Mark?
Oh my gosh. Yeah, it's become huge. And it's become a huge confusion for many people.
I couldn't agree more. And we're getting more and more contact with, you know, let's call them enthusiasts and the public asking, what is it? How do I use it? Can I do it myself? Can I have an installer do it? Why is it so expensive? But really, what it, you know, is it the same as my coffee cup? Is it the same as the floor I'm walking on? Because that's ceramic tile. So,
yeah, there you go.
We've launched a couple of new items that kind of fall under, let's call it that umbrella of ceramic. And we've had ceramic, let's call them base product for several years. And big picture is the simplicity of it is really it's all about protection and longevity. So remember the old Carnauba wax? It was born in, what would you say, the 50s, early 50s?
Oh, gosh.
Kind of came out long before us now. I can say that, right?
Well, I'm a late 50s, so I'm a baby boomer. So, but yeah, but that's okay. You know, I'm feeling pretty good. So I'm fine.
Awesome. But it gives you good protection, and consumers know that. And then, you know, polymers came out in the 80s and gives you better protection. And then now really ceramics are that next let's call it technology platform that has exploded onto both the professional and the consumer side. And again, it gives you protection from the elements and longevity. And that's what a lot of people are looking for, is I'd like a product that lasts a little bit longer to protect my classic or my investment I just bought of a new car. So we launched both a traditional professional applied one that really solves some of those problems. But the consumer one I want to talk about right now is super exciting for us. And there's so much noise out there, to your point. This is a legitimate coating called Ultimate Ceramic Coating that is a spray-on type of product available for anybody to use in your own driveway, in your garage, no matter who you are.
Okay.
So it gives you crazy water-beating slickness gloss, lasts longer than a traditional wax, whether that's Meguiar's or your favorite brand. But it really leverages that technology in let's call it an easy-to-use formulation, because some of these professional coatings that we'll talk about in a little bit is a little bit more sensitive to how they're applied.
Right.
So you got to have a little bit more knowledge, more patience, more know-how, and more experience to make them work. So I guess you could say we almost detuned some of that technology. Is that a fair word to say? Considering I was guest 283, which is a great small block Chevy. I'm going to leverage that right there. Detune it. How's that?
There you go. You did that nicely. Very nicely done. I had one of those motors in a car
I had long ago. I've had one too. They're great. They'll buzz up super high RPM. They're super durable. Oh, yeah. Love them. But Ultimate Ceramic Coating, it is, I played with this, oh my goodness gracious, it's probably 6 or 8 months.
Mm-hmm.
The ease of use, the durability are kind of the two key points. And it is just amazing. Now, of course, with any top coat, carnauba polymer or ceramic, the surface for best results should still be prepped. We all know that. You can't wax over oxidation. You can't wax or ceramic coat over a bunch of fallout or overspray. Mm-hmm. So for best results, you still want to prep your paint and then leverage this spray, wipe, spread, work it in. Grab yourself a fresh microfiber, wipe it off, flip it, and let it go. And you'll be amazed. It's pretty shocking, actually. Legit coating, though.
That's very cool. You've mentioned two ceramic products. So you have the Ultimate Ceramic Coating, spray-on, right?
That's correct. For the design, more for the do-it-yourselfer. And then we have what's called Beyond Ceramic Coating, called M888. You know, all of our pro products are numbered 105, 205. Going back to the early days of number 3, number 7, number 4, number 9.
Oh,
this
yeah.
is M888, believe it or not. Yes.
Yeah.
And we still have those on all of our bottles, believe it or not.
Wow.
This
nice.
Is
nice.
Yeah, we've had coatings outside the U.S. for a number of years, and we finally decided to kind of take that leap of faith to really clarify the market a little bit. Again, there's so much noise and misleading of how long products will last and things like that. This is simply a ceramic coating that anybody can buy. You don't need to be a trained certified installer. You don't have to have an area or region. So whether you're a mobile detailer, stationary detailer, a car wash, a dealership that wants to, you know, apply and upsell into a quality coating versus a standard carnauba polymer protection, this gives you the ability to do that. Big thing here is ease of use, because with pro coatings, there's a big problem called high spots.
Yeah.
And those high spots are just dry product that'll dry too quickly and you can't wipe them off. You got to go back and compound, start over, and reapply. So we took the ease of use was really our trigger for a coating technology and leveraged that 100% active ingredients, which is also kind of a game changer for the industry. So nothing is flashing off. Nothing is volatile going up into the air. You wipe it on, 100% sits there. Anything you wipe off is on your towel or onto that paint finish. Again,
nice.
Little bit more tricky to use, but don't want to scare anybody, but nowhere near. You don't need heat lamps. You don't need IR lamps. You don't need any of that technology. Anybody can do it with a little bit of patience, knowledge, and not even experience really, but a little bit of know-how. It comes with the SOP, a QR code, hit it. There's a video that shows you how to do everything. We're super excited for Beyond Ceramic Paint Coating M888, believe it or not.
I love it. Well, and you mentioned something really important, because for do-it-yourselfers that are at home with this new technology, it's important to learn how to do it right. And you guys have always produced, and of course, your smiling face is on many of these wonderful videos of how to do this stuff. And I'd encourage you to go. I'll put a link on Mike's show notes page, but Meguiar's is so easy to find. They've got such a robust website. This is really cool, because I'll tell you something. Last spring, I did something I've never done. I've never let anyone touch my cars. And I took my car to Kimball's detailing here in Gig Harbor, Joey Kimball, awesome guy. And I said, look, I'm going to let you, and these, my wife's car and my car are old BMWs. Her car is 19 years old. Mine's 18 years old, an X5 and an M3. And I said, I want this new ceramic coating put on my car. But the cars, you know, I've cared for my whole life, but with all these years, they have some scratches and things. So they did a two-stage paint correction, which you guys have products for that. Polish is the term many of us know about. So using random orbitals and, you know, if you know how to use a direct drive, but I would caution, start the other way. And they made that paint look perfect. And then they put a two-step ceramic coating on it. This was a professional line, so not what you're doing, because I was too nervous. I'd never used it, and I didn't want to mess things up. And I will tell, I've told this to so many people now, my old days of using a carnauba wax was always my favorite, or some type of a polymer wax, are over. Ceramic, oh my God. And living in the environment I live in, I smile now every time I wash my car or I do a quick spray with a product. And it's just so easy. And the car looks so good. It's, listeners, if you've not gone down this path, whether you hire somebody professional and they use the professional line of Meguiar's, or you do it yourself, and now that you have this product, I think it's wonderful. You got to do this because it will change your life. I'm just amazed by it. It's wonderful.
You were spot on. And we actually get that question a lot, is should I, can I, is it the right thing to do to ceramic coat my paint? And there's so many benefits, and you hit just about every single one of them, from look, slickness, durability. They call it self-cleaning, where the water beads just roll right off. It's easier to dry. All these factors, but the big thing is, if it's exposed to the elements, you drive it, you're in an area where you get hit with rain, snow, sleet, mag chloride, salt, all that fun stuff. Certainly, ceramic technology is beneficial. However, sometimes we'll tell people, if your car is only driven in the summer one time a month, and you like to polish it with your dual action polisher and massage it and have that emotional connection, yeah, maybe you don't want a ceramic coating. You want to stay with traditional polishes and waxes. And guess what? That's okay too.
Yeah.
Now there's options for everybody. You know, maybe your daily gets ceramic coated and your other one doesn't, or vice versa. So it's so many great choices out there.
You hit the nail on the head, because with my my Orange Crush that so many people know about, that I've sold to a guy just north of me, that car always got hand massaged. You know, I loved the carnauba wax. I loved the experience of running my hands over that car. I didn't go ceramic, but the drivers, I did. And I just can't emphasize enough for you listeners, give this a look. Talk to people that have done it.
Yeah.
Talk to people at Meguiar's. How is this okay to do? And I want to ask you this. If somebody has always been waxing their cars, if they're going to transfer over to ceramic coatings, what's the process? Because you can't, or I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, you can't just put this over the top of a waxed vehicle.
Yeah, you're spot on. And that's probably not the best way to do it, because you're not going to get that adhesion. So whether you're doing it yourself or have an installer, you know, put on a professionally installed or beyond ceramic in the middle, any of that, coatings like to be the surface prep. And then you can use any type of anything from a glass cleaner to a surface prep, a grease and wax remover, and really strip off, let's call it, any oils or anything that may be left on there from carnauba to polymers. And it really gives those ceramics the ability to grab, bite, cure, bond. You know, there's all kinds of words that different companies use. And that's what's going to give you the maximum protection, especially if you're getting into that professionally installed. They'll go through multiple steps, very similar to a body shop that paints cars. Prep that vehicle, then they lay down that paint. If they don't do it just right, you don't get good adhesion. So there's that scenario. So you were spot on with that whole analogy of make sure it's prepped right, and then you're good to go.
Cool. Now, did we get them all, or I'm trying to count? You said five new products. I think we've talked about four here. Is that right?
We have one more that's in the retail line. Two more. I want to highlight our headlight, if you don't mind. Take a little minute to talk about our new headlight restoration kit. Because, again, another, let's call it, confusing category through time now. And there's been some options out there where headlights are, obviously we know they turn brown. That's the coating on the outside beginning to oxidize. You can remove that, but if you don't put that coating back on, or that sealant back on, it's going to brown quicker. The great news is a lot of companies have embraced that, and there's all kinds of options to do that. Whether that's, we have our heavy duty kit that you can sand, you put on a buffer, you tape it, you do all that, or some simple spray on products. But we launched one called Ultimate Headlight Restoration Kit that falls right in the middle. And the reason we say that is we listen to people, and they wanted the experience of sanding. Is you need to really sand with 1,000 and 3,000 to get rid of that old oxidized surface and really prep that surface properly.
Exfoliate.
Exfoliate is a great, what perfect yeah. word, just like paint care, you know, just like removing oxidation.
Yeah, it's cool.
People were confused with putting a buffer on and putting a little wool pad, and they weren't comfortable buffing on their headlights. So we simply said, let's take some technology that is a ceramic sealant, impregnated onto a little sachet, like a wipe, and you can actually wipe right over the top of that 3,000 grit, very similar to how you clear over a sanded surface, but you're wiping, you're not spraying. So you get rid of the overspray, it's easy, and you'll get about 18 months on this. And the first question we were getting asked at SEMA was, can I do this on a brand new headlight? Mm. And obviously our recommendation is, because the surface needs to be prepped and sanded, we're back to that word adhesion, there's no need to do it on a new headlight. Don't cut up and begin to sand a new headlight. Wait till it diminishes over time. So this is more of a ultimate headlight restoration kit. Easy to use with great results. That doesn't hit the mark until about March, so you have to wait a little bit on that one.
Now, you can put your ceramic coatings on a headlight surface, correct?
Yeah, you can do it. You would just use either our spray or a professional one. We can call it a brand. Absolutely. You can even put carnauba wax on headlights if you want. So there's no reason to sand and scuff them until they need sanded and scuffed, so to speak.
Very cool. Well, it sounds like you're just making life easier and easier for us detail freaks. And I think that's tremendous. And I wish I could have been there in person to see everything, but it sounds like you have once again brought it all to market, which is really, really cool. You know, I wanted to ask you this question. What is, because you've talked to so many people, and this might be a bit of a challenge, but what is your do-it-yourselfers biggest challenge when it comes to car care? What's something you hear over and over and over again?
Oh, that's an easy one. What do I use on my car? That is the biggest, simplest question that I'm sure every manufacturer, including us, car care manufacturer, gets all the time. And that's probably a good thing too, because whether you cash out X amount of dollars and you got your first brand new car that you could afford, or the one that you maybe aspire to, the last thing you want to do is damage it. So you got that side of the business. What do I use on my car? But then you've also got the restoration people and preservation. They're bringing it back. I just bought a used car. It's all I can afford. How do I make it look better? What do I do on my situation? So it really works down both sides of that coin. And that's where, what are you working on? What are your goals? How much time do you want to spend? That's going to help us help you pick, choose the right product. And then again, we'll help you how to use it properly. Don't forget about that back label. Tells you how to do it all. Again, we talked earlier about right product, right technique, you get the wow results. So by far, what do I use on my car?
Well, and it all depends, right?
It all depends. Yeah. And some people get a little bit, let's call it frustrated when we don't have an exact, here's another great, what's your best wax? What are you looking for? That's like saying, what's the best restaurant in town? What are you feeling tonight?
What do you feel like eating?
Yeah. What's your budget? How much time do you have? What's the dress code? Mm. We'll pick that product or restaurant up for you, but give us a few details to make sure you were wowed in that experience.
Well, once again, for listeners, I say go to Meguiar's. You can give them a call or go online, and they'll ask you all these great questions to align you with the right product to fit your needs. And that's the great thing about what you guys have been doing. Just like you did that first visit I paid to you way back when. back then, I would have never touched a machine, and you convinced me it's okay to use a random orbital. And those have come a long way. I mean, to look at the market, is just full of
them
now.
Exploded, yes.
Oh, it's incredible. And even back then I said, are you sure? Because I've seen cars destroyed by these. Well, those are direct drives, not random orbitals, and they're using the wrong products. And I went home with this confidence, bought myself a machine and said, okay, I can, wow, look at this. I can do this. This is really cool.
I can do this.
I can, yeah. Oh, look, Mom, I am smart, just like you always told me I was.
Love it.
You've enlightened us as you always do, and that's why it's been far too long since I've had you on the show, but I'm so happy to have you back. You know, I always ask people if there's a book they like to share, and I'm going to ask you that. I'm wondering if there's a book that you like to share that doesn't have to be about car care. Maybe it's a self-help book or something that you've read of late with all the traveling you do that you might want to share.
Gosh, let's think here. Yeah, there's a book that I was shared with probably three to five years ago that I think kind of hits home and broadens, whether it's personal or business. And I think probably everybody listening may know about this book. It's called Grit, The Power of Passion and Perseverance. Okay, it's by Angela Duckworth. I think everybody knows this book, and it's just about passion, perseverance can really just pave the way. And talking about grit, don't give up. You know, just keep digging and going, and you will make it. So I think that's probably the one that comes to mind that, I don't say hit me hard, but really is top of mind for myself of business and personal life, period.
Wonderful. Great recommendation. So once again, you've enlightened us. You've gotten us excited. I'm sure many listeners now are ready to go out and give some new products a test and try. And I encourage you to do that. It's fun. And what I always say is, you know, if you don't want to do it on your vehicle, let your neighbor know. You'll detail their car. Or better yet, go rent a car. Don't tell the rental companies. And practice on a rental car. I used to do that all the time.
Well, we do it too here today. We still do it today.
Well, because rental cars have so many scratches from those car washes they run them through.
They're perfect.
It's a perfect test example. So there's a little tip for you today. Before I let you go, could you share maybe some words of inspiration, advice, or wisdom when it comes to caring for your vehicles?
When it comes to caring for your vehicles, I'm going to say something that Barry Meguiar taught me a long time ago, and we still share this, let's call it phrase today, because it means so much. Frequent car care is easy car care. So it's almost like cleaning your house. The more you do it, the easier it is, the better it looks, the more value you're going to maintain. But you know, a lot of people don't have enough time to restore, or if they let it go for a long ways, it does take it all day on Saturday to bring it back. But if you never let it get that bad, you never have to spend that time. So frequent car care is easy car care. And still sticks with us today.
Well, it's so true. And if you do that, and especially again with these new ceramics, you can clean your car very easy. And if you live in an environment like I do, where the weather's a little nasty, you can do it in your garage with a whole stack of microfiber towels, spray on, wipe off. I do it all the time. My neighbors laugh saying, oh, you're going to make sure it rains again tomorrow, Mark, huh? But you know what? It does make things easier. It's just like caring for your home. If you let things go, you're going to have a lot more work down the road. Mm-hmm. So words to live by from, of course, the great leader there, Barry Meguiar. Always run into him during car week. Always say hello. It's wonderful. So I think that's cool. How can people learn more about Meguiar's and get tips and tricks and find all the products and where to buy them?
Gosh, just about anywhere. You said that earlier, is we are anywhere from Meguiar's.com, M-E-G-U-I-A-R-S. Or on social at Meguiar's. You can get us on live chat, direct message, just about any way possible. And of course, we still have on the back of every one of our bottles the phone number to our solutions hub that's in the new building as well. So whatever type of communication you like to do, we'd love to hear from you and help you or guide you. Let's call it in your car care journey, I guess you could say.
Oh, absolutely. And I want to do a shout out. Thank you to our mutual buddy here, Alan Nguyen, who got you back on the show here. So, Alan, thank you for lining this whole thing up. He's a great supporter. Mike, thank you for taking a little pit stop out of the garage and spending it with us and sharing a little bit of what's new at Meguiar's. Always good to catch up with you. Can't wait to come and visit your new facility early next year. I'm going to take you up on that offer. Until you and I talk again, my friend, I'll see you in a shiny car down the road.
Take care. Thank you.
You're welcome. This has been fun. 20, 50, or 100 years from now, will there be a workforce to care for the collector vehicles we love? With auto shop programs disappearing across the country, it's a question we enthusiasts have to ask. That's why I support the RPM Foundation, which exists to ensure that the critical skills necessary to preserve and restore these vehicles aren't lost to time. One of the many ways RPM, which is short for Restoration, Preservation, and Mentorship, is accomplishing this goal is through workforce development initiatives The RPM apprenticeship program enables the next generation of artisans to earn a living while they learn the craft of restoring and preserving these vehicles directly from industry professionals. The Endangered Skills Program documents the process of masters training future craftspeople on a variety of critical skills in danger of being lost forever. For more information on how the RPM Foundation is driving the future of the collector vehicle skills trade, visit RPM Foundation today. They're one of the charities of choice here on Cars Yeah.
Thank you so much for joining us on today's ride here at Cars Yeah. Drive on over to carsyeah.com to find show notes and inspiring automotive fun. Download your free copy of Filler Up, a fun book filled with gorgeous photographs of fuel filler fun, including quotes from more inspiring automotive enthusiasts. Download your copy today, and we'll see you next time on Cars Yeah!